Hi, I'm Michael Bolton. I'm a tester. I teach a course and a methodology called rapid software testing with James Bach. One of the things I have been listening to these days is a series on CBC Radio called How to Think About Science. The most interesting two pieces in this sequence of podcasts are interviews with one is a fellow named Simon Schaffer, professor of history. He talks about a dispute that broke out in the 17th century between Robert Boyle and Thomas Hobbes. Boyle had invented this fascinating thing that helped with scientific experiments. It was an air pump. And he was using it to demonstrate experiments on the vacuum. And he did three amazing things. One is he invented this very sophisticated for its time machine. The second thing he did was he invented a protocol by which an experiment would be performed with witnesses around, looking at what went on. And the third thing that he did, he created a new style of writing, a form of what he called virtual witnessing, in which he had the people who were witnesses to the experiment write down what had happened so that the experiment could be reproduced. Hobbes didn't believe that this would work because Hobbes held that people weren't going to give up their treasured beliefs unless they were forced to. An enormous dispute broke out. Hobbes held that there was no such thing as a vacuum, and Boyle was in the process of demonstrating that there was. This same kind of dispute is happening in software testing at the moment. It's been happening for a long time. There's been argument about ways to do software testing, and I welcome those things. I think those things are wonderful because there aren't any true answers on how to do this stuff. There isn't consensus. There isn't agreement, and I don't think that it's necessary to have that in order for us to make progress. There has to be a marketplace of ideas, and those ideas have to contend with one another in order for us to get to what might be important in our context. The second fascinating story in the sequence of podcasts, a fellow named Sajay Samuel, who's a professor of accounting, has a lot of interest in the history of science. He makes some really interesting distinctions about the difference between experiment and experience. And when we say somebody is an experienced man, what we mean is that man has been through many different varying kinds of conditions, various different kinds of circumstances that contribute to his understanding and view of the world, that he has solved problems in various kinds of places. That's very different from an experiment, right? You can do an experiment as few times as one. And in an experiment, you have to control things. You have to filter out noise. You have to separate the things that you choose to observe from the things that you don't, and make sure the things that you don't choose to observe are not changing. That, to me, reminds me of a very focused kind of approach to testing, and especially to test automation, looking at one aspect of the way software behaves. But I think we need to think about experience more. I think that the coming revolution in software testing is going to be about how people experience software, how they interact with it in a messy, complex world of systems that are interdependent and that can interfere with one another and can amplify the effects that they have on one another. I think that's the next place to go. That means software testing is going to get a lot more complicated, and that means it's going to get a lot more fun.